New 10-metre air rifle, 4.5mm calibre, maximum of 5.5 kilograms for these very bespoke rifles. Cost thousands and thousands of dollars. And well, earlier today the qualification started just behind us, and it was the Italian Campriani who qualified first with an Olympic record of 630.2, averaging 10.5. Not far behind the Russian is Lenikov, 10.483. Peter Gorsa third, the Croat. The two Ukrainians qualifying next to each other, Kulish and Sakhov. Very calm and collected. And then the very experienced Peter Sidi of Hungary, also qualifying here in sixth place. And then we mentioned already, Abhinav Bindra of India, another vastly experienced athlete, coming in seventh place. And Ilya Jahaika of Belarus was the man who just squeaked Zhao Yi Thai of China on count back. Both had the same score, 6.25.5, but they were separated by count back in the 10 ring. So that's what we're looking at now. Just a reminder of how it will work. Two lots of three shots to get us underway in this final. 150 seconds, 2.5 minutes per series. And then the single shots of 50 seconds. And after the second single shot, we start the elimination. Every two shots, we will eliminate somebody else. That's our lineup. A good spread of nationalities. But as we said, Ukraine have two athletes in this final. In shooting position A, Peter Gorsa, been shooting since the age of 8, third Olympics and first final. Peter Sidi is in B from Hungary, 37 years of age. This his fifth Olympics and second final. India's Abhinav Bindra, the gold medalist from Beijing, another hugely experienced athlete, 33 years of age. Vladimir Lenikov of Russia, just 21, but ranked number 5, and is looking to make a splash in his first Olympics. Sakhov, another athlete in his first Olympics, a man from Ukraine, has only been shooting internationally for 2 years. Sergey Kulish of Ukraine, second of our athletes from Ukraine, 23-year-old, world number 7. He's in shooting position H. And then we also have Sarkov. Niccolo Campriani, the silver medalist from London, must be one of the favourites. He's in F. And Jahaika of Belarus made the final at London, looking for a medal. He is in G. So here we go. This the first series of three shots as we get underway in the 10-metre air rifle competition for the men. Sidi of Hungary. Gorsa away on the right-hand side as we look at the athletes. In position A, 10.3 from Maslenikov. The best so far along with Sidi. What can Gorsa do? Last to shoot. A 10.4. And that is good. Campriani has just popped a 10.7. So the Italian is in first place, but we have a lot of shots to go. 19 more shots to go in this final. Bindra, 5 Olympics. He's only 33 years of age, Bindra. Has had his problems with back injuries, and all these athletes tend to. This asymmetric bending back position, not good for your back, which is why they have these very heavy canvas and leather suits on. He'd be happy with that second shot. He 9.7 for him. Gorsa shooting well. 9.8 though for him, not so good the second time round after the 10.4. Dorsa, who broke his left hand when he was at school in a bike accident, but overcame those injuries. Campriani having a problem with that second shot, that 9.2, but that's better. Need to go hard, need to be brave, have courage. And the we're not being eliminated, these shots are absolutely crucial. Campriani back with a 10.4, started with a 10.7. He is in the medal positions at the moment. Clock counting down. And there you go. Back to 2 minutes 30 on the clock, as you can see in the far side. And that's how it's looking at the moment. Kulish, Sidi, Campriani and Gorsa. Campriani and Gorsa tied on 30.3. At the bottom, Nitsarkov, who is in a spot of bother. A little bit adrift. Very much adrift at the bottom. Shooting an 8.3 to begin with and then some nines. It's the man under pressure. Zarkov of Ukraine. Chahika the next above him in seventh. More than 2 points ahead. Campriani. Of course, partner, another shooter, the Italian Petra Zublazing. Won the gold at the European Games in the mixed 10-meter air rifle together. Keep in the 10 ring and you're doing something right. Much more stable than in the pistol event, of course. They don't have any of the enhancing clothing, the performance enhancing clothing. So you want to be in that 10 ring all the time. As we say, Campriani 10.503, his average in qualifying. Kulish just struggling a little bit with a 9.5. And in shooting position H, right at the far end of this range, the world ranked number 7, just 23 years of age. Been shooting for 13 years despite his tender age. And a 10.5 is better from him. In the city at the moment, top of the pile, 10.3, followed by a 10.8. Goodness me, as we know, the bullseye, the 10.9 score in this decimal system is only half a millimetre wide, and each fraction, each point percentage is 0.25 a millimetre, and that's good from Zarkov. Well, he was struggling, wasn't he, in that first series, but 10.7, 10.6 and a 10.7, and that is great work. He's still, because of his poor opening through shots, down at the bottom of the pile at the moment. Gorsa with one still to get away, 10.7 and a 10.3. Taking his time, and a 9.7, and he'll be disappointed with that. But Gorsa just outside the medal, 61 dead, his score at the moment. And this is how it looks after the two sets of three shots. Sidi just 0.1 ahead of Maslenikov, who is 0.3 ahead of Campriani. And Gorsa, Kulish not very far away. Zarkov showing some form, but it might have been a little bit too little too late. He's had a very poor first series, a much better second. Can he pull himself up by his bootstraps? On to the individual shots then. 50 seconds for each shot. After the second of these, we will lose our first athlete. And then, almost into walk drive, it feels. Sidi Maslenikov, 0.1 between them at the moment, at the top of the rankings. 10 from Maslenikov. Well, Sidi, 9.6. I'll be disappointed with that. He will see himself slide down the ranking. At the other end, a 10.1 from Zarkov. But it was bettered by Chahika. So Sidi down into third after that shot. It's Kulish of Ukraine who shot a very impressive 10.9. Campriani there or thereabouts, 9.9 from him though. We'll be hoping for better in fourth place at the moment. So then, who will it be? It looks very much like Sarkov has a lot of work to do there. And only if Chahaker stumbles will he stay in this competition. Rani Amal on the left-hand side. Take from Campriani, absolutely splendid from him, and a good shot from Sarkov, but it wasn't good enough. 10.1 sees him having to make way. And from Ukraine, and his first Olympics, was the European champion in 2014. And from Lviv, the Sports Army Club, has to take his seat. The first of those two athletes from Ukraine have been eliminated. So then, two more shots and we will find out who takes seventh place. Two more shots. At the moment, Kulish, the other Ukrainian, top of the pile. He's been happily shooting, shot a 10.9 in the first of those two series earlier on, so he's in good form. 10.9 or 10.4, so he's going to see you somewhere near the top. Campriani has Lenikov, they are tied for second on 82, just 0.1 behind Kulish. It's very tight, this competition, certainly between the top three, and then a drop of 0.8 down to Bindra in fourth. Point two from Campriani. A little smile from him. A 10.6 from Kulish. Sees that advantage just increasing a little bit. This is Maslenikov. 10.3. Excellent from him. 10.8 from Bindra has closed the gap considerably. Excellent shooting from him. And one more shot to see who will drop out next. Sidi and Chahaker. Sidi, who shot a 10.4 but had a very poor couple of shots before that, is in danger here and needs to keep his concentration. Chahaker and Sidi. Chahaker just 0.3 behind Sidi. Shot very quickly and shot well, Sidi. And Chahaker shot well as well. That's going to be very tight. 10.5 from Chahaker, but a 10.5 also from Sidi. Very, very tight indeed. In fact, just getting an update on the score. And Chahaker has just, it was in fact a 9.8 from Gorsa. And Gorsa is the man who has dropped down into seventh place. Well, he looked like he was okay and cruising through, but all of a sudden that 9.8 has hurt him. He shot a 10.5, but too many nines in his final. And Petar Gorsa is the man who has to make way and take seventh place in his third Olympic Games. And you see, very disappointed with what has happened there in the finals hall today. So then, six left in this competition. Very tight, as you can see, two athletes tied for third, Bindra and Campriani. Kulish, 0.2 his gap between first, and Maslenikov in second. Kulish, Ukrainian, Russian Maslenikov. Those are the two vying for the gold medal at the moment, but it is very, very tight between the top four, in fact. 10.7 from Bindrop. Big Indian contingent cheering there. Maslenikov, 10.1. A chance for Kulish perhaps to widen the gap, and at 10.8. Certainly has done that. Half a point now between first and second. Campriani and Bindra. 10.7, 9.7 from Campriani. So Bindra's hauled himself above Maslenikov into second place. A real change in fortunes there for Bindra with that 10.7. And he's been shooting ever so well. The last four or five shots, 10.7, 10.7, 10.8. Another 10.7 earlier on as well. So all of a sudden he's finding some form. Half a point rather, behind Kulish at the moment. Chahekin is, who's in danger of dropping out. Half a point behind Petr Sidi. He shot a 10.4. Sidi shot a 10.6. They are the two in danger of leaving us prematurely. The shoot-off to avoid sixth place, in effect. Both shooting well at the moment. 10.1, but another 10.1. So it is as you are. And Chahekha is the man. A little shake of the head. He knows that his dream of an Olympic medal is over. Certainly in this competition. Most of these will double up into the three positions later on in the Olympics. And from Grodno in Belarus. Has to make way. World rank 24. His second final, he was seventh in London. And well, he's gone one better here. Has to settle for sixth place here in Rio. So five left. Sidi is the man who has some work to do here. And, it's pretty tight. It's 0.6, and over two shots that could all change. Just a little spread out. It's very tight between Maslenikov in second and Bindra in third. Certainly, Kulish is not insurmountable. Ukrainian at the top of the rankings, the 23-year-old. Number seven is Bindra, who is in third place, in the bronze medal place at the moment. And 0.7 won't help Bindra, and he knows it as well. Kulish, 9.8. Yeah, all faltering. It was a 10.3 from Maslenikov, who is within 0.2 now of Kulish. And 10.3 from Campriani as well. So it's all tightened up a little bit. 1.1 between the top four. And it's not that much of a difference between Sidi and Campriani. One more shot to see whether Sidi can stay in this competition. Sidi in his fifth Olympics, second Olympic final after Beijing. And he will be a contender in the three position rifle event later on as well. And four between the two. Quick shot from Sidi. We wait on Campriani, and it's 10.5. And that will consign Sidi to the fifth place. Good shooting when it mattered from Campriani. And we'll have to settle for fifth place. And he was Shoot of the Year in 2009. World rank number 11. And there's another event in which to try and get that precious medal. Sixth in Beijing, his best up to now. And he will have a fifth place finish here in Rio. So then, four left. And as you can see, it is pretty tight between top and bottom. Just 0.6 between first and fourth, and just 0.2 between Campriani in fourth and Bindra in the bronze medal position. Two more shots then to see who will miss out agonizingly at the last hurdle on a medal. Breathing and heartbeat, crucial in this competition. Need to keep calm, need to keep the heartbeat down, need to look to shoot between the heartbeat. You see very different styles of holding this rifle. Some hold it on palms, some on knuckles. As Lenikov, 10.2 and 9.9 from Kulish, who drops down. Bindra with a 9.9. Campriani with a 10.6 leapfrogs into second place. So there's a lot of change going on here. This is the Italian. Look how calm and composed he is. And this is the sharp end of the competition. He needs to keep doing that if he is to take another medal. Remember, the silver medalist from London. So Bindra now, at 9.9, finds himself 0.2 adrift of Kulish, who shot a 9.9 as well. Bindra at 10.2. What will Kulish do here? Oh, it's a 10. It's going to be a sudden death shoot-off. Equal scores. Well, what drama here. The gold medalist from Beijing, Bindra, taking on the 23-year-old Ukrainian. And it really is. Whoever gets closest to the centre will progress. And your heartbeat will be racing here. And it's just a question of who. There we are, the deep breath from Kulish. Who can calm themselves? Who can keep focused? Hat, the blinders, the ear defenders, all there to block out everything else but the shot. But they will know what this means. This is a shot for a medal. Simple as that. Didn't help the heart rate. Bindra very quickly away. It's a 10. And Kulish. It's a 10.5. A 10.5 from Kulish. So it is Bindra who has missed out here. The oldest man in the field. Agonizing way not to get yourself into the medals and onto the podium. Fifth Olympics, he's only 33. An autobiography after his gold medal, a shot at history. And you can see huge support, big sport in India. In fourth place after a shoot-off, the man who is putting something back into the sport of shooting. He's set up a foundation to help athletes with the cost of shooting. He will be desperately disappointed not to be in the medals. These three are, though, Campriani, Maslenikov, Kulish. Has been top for quite some time, now in third place. We see him just trying to relax himself. Every one of these athletes now at the shooting positions has a medal. Big question is, what colour will it be? 0.3 between Kulish and Maslenikov. Campriani 0.4 ahead of the Russian. Into the top two then on our screen. Oh, and 9.9 from Campriani. Maslenikov doesn't really capitalise. And we've been waiting. Just shot there. Kulisha. 10.3 brings him up to 0.1 of Maslenikov. 0.3 between all three of them. It's a very, very tight final stage of this 10-meter air rifle competition. That's how close it is. That's the margins that will settle these medals here. Not allowed to put the pellet into the air rifle until they are instructed to. So then, who is going to take the bronze and who will stay in this competition? Kulish, Maslenikov, keep an eye on Capriani as well. 10 from Maslenikov. It may well not be good enough. It's certainly given a chance to Kulish. A 10.3 for him, and he will leapfrog the Russian. A 10.4 from Capriani keeps him top of the table. And Vladimir Maslenikov, world rank number 5, just 21 years of age, almost 22, the junior world champion of 2014, who won here in April in the World Cup, will take the bronze medal. So two are left. Two shots now, shot 19 and 20, to decide who will take silver and who will take gold. And 0.4 is nothing. I assure you, anything can happen here. Capriani, silver in London, who had every chance of getting gold until the final stages. He has published a book on how to overcome the fear of failure. I wonder if he's heeding some of those thoughts now. Topping the table, Niccolo Campriani, 0.4 ahead of Sergei Kulish of Ukraine. Two shots then to settle this. Campriani, 10.6, excellent stuff. Now Kulish needs to respond to this. A 10.4, well, it's good, but it was brilliant from the Italian. He's now 0.6 ahead. Now that is not unsurmountable. However, he has to be the favourite surely for the gold medal. Had the gold, of course, in the three position event in London. Silver in this. Can he better that now? Final shot of this competition, and it all comes down to this. Can Capriani keep his cool? Kulish has to just block everything else out. Shoot as well as he possibly can and just hope that Capriani has an off shot. This to settle gold then. Oh, it's not good from Kulish. He knows it. 9.8. Capriani, this should be easy for him. A 10.7 to finish it off, and the Italian takes gold medal here at the Rio Olympics. 10-meter air rifle, silver in London. He goes one better in 2016. His second shooting gold after the three position gold in London. And he was brilliant in those closing stages. Just kept hitting high shots. 10.6 and a 10.7 to close things out. And you have to also say what an excellent work. A silver for Sergei Kulish from Ukraine, 23 years of age, the world rank number 7. He's been shooting for 13 years already. He will be delighted with that as well. But this is our superstar at the moment, Niccolo Campriani, 28 years of age. Extremely experienced already. The woman, the coach for Italy, able to have a word now and congratulate him in person. Petra Zublazing, also at the Olympics. His partner will be delighted as well. I'm sure she's watching. Smiles all round from the Italian, and why not? The 2012 Shooter of the Year. That's another medal, his third Olympic medal, his first of these games. And who would count him out in the 50-meter rifle three positions competition as well? Another good attendance for the shooting. The Deodora cluster of venues, quite a long way north from the Olympic Park, in the Deodora Army Base. Another excellent final, exciting, right to the death. Here's confirmation. The bronze going to Russia's Vladimir Maslenikov, Ukraine's Sergei Kulish taking the silver, an Olympic record and a gold medal for Italy's Niccolo Campriani.
Medaille de bronze représentant la Fédération de Russie.
Bronze medalist representing the Russian Federation.
Medaille de bronze representando a Federação da Rússia.
Vladimir Maslenikov.
21-year-old, world ranked number 5, the junior world champion in 2014. What a big future he has. It starts here with the bronze medal at the Rio 2016 Olympics. Couldn't quite shoot the big numbers he needed in the last few shots. So you get a different medal, but he'll be delighted with what he has here. And I'm sure we'll see him at more world events and more Olympic Games. Bronze medal then for Vladimir Maslenikov of Russia.
Silver medalist representing Ukraine.
Medalha de prata representando a Ucrânia.
Sergei Kulish.
Well, he was 18th in London. Substantially better here. Survived that fourth place shoot-off, the drama against Abhinav Bindra, and then carried on shooting really well towards the end to take the silver medal. Shooting since he was 10 years of age. Cherkasy in Ukraine, now 23 years of age. World rank number 7. Another one for the future as well. Silver medal then for Sergei Kulish of Ukraine.
Gold medalist, an Olympic champion, representing Italy.
Medaglia di oro e campeão olímpico, representando a Italia.
Niccolo Campriani!
Silver in London 4 years ago. He's gone one better here. A man who published a book about how to overcome a fear of failure. Hasn't failed in any shape or form in his 10-meter air rifle competition. Remember, he got the gold in the three positions competition, the 50-meter rifle in London. And he has that to come as well. This is third Olympic medal, his first gold in the 10-meter air rifle competition. Still only 28 years of age. Gold then for Italy's Niccolo Campriani.
Ladies and gentlemen, the anthem of Italy.
Senhoras e senhores, o hino da Itália.
it's one of the longer anthems you'll hear in Rio. And that man there, Niccolo Campriani, savoured every moment of it. Just to confirm then, bronze medal for Russia and Vladimir Maslenikov. The silver for Ukraine, Sergei Kulish. And the gold goes to Italy and Niccolo Campriani.